Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Soldier Field on the campus of Rogers State University for this afternoon's game between Lubbock Christian University and your Rogers State Hillcats. Referee for today's game is Edwin Smith. He's assisted by Ron Coulson and Joe Porter. Christian Chefs. Number one, Hunter Gaines. Number three, Justin Spatrice. Number five, Aaron Fossal. Number seven, Billy Ford. Number eight, Nick Ford. Number nine, Stuart McDonald. Number 10, Jorge Martinez. Number 11, Cornell Lemia. Number 12, Cody Scott. Number 19, Matt Forty. Number 22, Byron Gold.
Welcome into Hillcat Soccer on rsuhillcats.com/live. And we run down the starting lineup of Lubbock Christian University. The Shaps, coached by Kyle Baird, assisted by Cody Guzman. Starting at goalkeeper is Hunter Gans. At midfield, Justin Dupriest. Aaron Dossel gets the start along the defense, as does Billy Forbes. Nick Corey, Stuart McDonald, George Martinez, Jorge Martinez, Cornell and Villa, Tony Stock, Matt Morgan, and Byron Knowles round out the starting lineup for Lubbock Christian. We enter today's game at 6-1-2 overall, 0-0-1 in Sooner Athletic Conference play. Starting lineup for the Rogers State Hillcats, who enter today's game at 5-3, 0-1 in Sooner Athletic Conference play. Record of 4-1 at home. At goalkeeper, it's the redshirt freshman out of Bixby, Oklahoma, Jeremy Swift. Along the defensive back line, Marco Bucca, the senior out of Croatia. Ryan Coffin, the senior out of Mansfield, Texas. Brian Jones, the junior out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. And David Bell, a junior out of Nowata, Oklahoma, rounds out the back four. Griffin Kane gets his first start of the season at midfield. Justin Friesen mans the middle at center mid, and Adam Harmon on the right side, a freshman out of Sand Springs, Oklahoma. The front line has a lot of speed and talent. Muhammad Shaban, the freshman out of Tulsa, joined by Gary Aruz, the junior out of Bolivia, Oklahoma, transfer from ORU, and Enrique Souza, the senior from Sao Paulo, Brazil, rounds out that starting lineup in the front three. The Hillcats run a 4-3-3 formation, and the head referee is Edwin Smith. RSU is coached by Derek Larkin, assisted by Sean Slater. Ryan Wagan, head athletic trainer, is Rebecca Riddle. We take a moment for the national anthem and come back with Trent Baker's thoughts for this contest at Soldier Field. As the Hillcats huddle and get set for this game, LCU huddled over on their side of the field as well. Steve Braun and Trent Baker, happy to have you with us here on a beautiful day in Claremore for some Hillcats soccer as Lubbock Christian and Rogers State get set to go at it. Hillcats looking for their first win in Sooner Athletic Conference play. Same can be said for Lubbock Christian. And what are the keys to the game, you think, for RSU going into this one?
I think today, looking in the midfield, definitely going to have a strong game from the three midfielders. Forward's going to have to finish their opportunities. We always know that this is a very strong back line the Hillcats have. Got two guys in Marco Bukva and David Bell are definitely enforcers. Two big guys in the back, Brian Jones and Ryan Kaufman. It's very hard to get past them. They're quality players. In the midfield, we got Justin Friesen, probably one of my favorite players on this Hillcat team. Griffin Kane, good to see Griff getting the start. Got two guys very calm on the ball, level-headed, good distributors. Got a freshman coming in, Adam Harmon. Reminds me a lot of a guy I played with, Jaime Perez. He's a good footwork, good quality, level-headed player. Up top, Enrique Souza is definitely a game changer. Muhammad Shaban, freshman coming in, guy who definitely finds himself in the right place at the right time a lot. And Gary Aruz, there's, even more you can be said about him. Comes in from ORU, very quality player, skilled player, distributes the ball well, finds opportunities, and quality all the way around from those guys. And I think we'll definitely need to see a lot of possession out of the Hillcats, stringing quite a few passes together and getting on the end of crosses. And we'll see a good finish if, you know, they can accomplish all these things.
As the Hillcats and Chaps are set to go, LCU will kick it away. Billy Forbes is in there at the midfield circle, and he'll tap it off to Purnell and Bila. LCU plays it along that back line. Plays it up to Jorge Martinez. Near side, that one off the mark just a bit and out of bounds. and a throw-in opportunity for RSU. Edwin Smith will push Bukba back about 10 yards. Marco tried to sneak up. He plays it into Ruse. Nice ball into the 18-yard box here. No one home, and Hunter Gans comes away with it. He'll roll it down the far sideline. LCU has it on the back line. Play it near side, controlled by DuPriest. Into the middle, that's Griffin Kane. Kane, a great ball to Muhammad Shaban. Near side, and he tries to sneak it in on the near post. Unable to do so as Gans was there and drops down to his knees to corral that one.
It's unlucky. Shaban's first touch led him down there. He took himself wider and cut his angle down on the goal. It's a good quality play from Griffin there, finding the open man on a great run by Shaban. Hope to see more of that this game.
Griffin Kane, a guy that has played for Derek Larkin for quite a while.
Definitely.
Played in high school at Bishop Kelly, where Larkin came from. And then has played now 3 years, or 4 years, excuse me, here for the Hillcats and under Larkin. Kaufman has it on the back line. You talked about that middle part of the defensive backfield. Kaufman and Jones provide a solid group in the middle.
Yeah, those guys are hard to get by. You know, if you get it by once, then you know, you're going to have trouble getting it by them twice.
Kaufman,
good in the air, definitely.
Kaufman's a senior. Jones, a junior, but it sure seems like he's a senior, how long he's been here, and just the way he plays.
Yeah, Brian's spent some good time on the field in these past couple years.
There's a ball on the far sideline, fought for, and not often you see David Bell knocked down, but I guess there's a first for everything.
Yeah, David Bell's the kind of guy that I like watching him play. He's definitely going to get into a forward or get into an outside mid, whoever's got the ball with him, and they're going to think twice every time they receive the ball, knowing he's coming at them.
LCU has it, plays it into the midfield circle, dribbling around there, hands it off quickly, passes it off, should I say. Loses control is Nambila. Ruse has it. Over to the far side, that's Enrique Souza. Souza getting his first touch of the game. Drops it off to Ruse, and Gary just misplays that one a bit, and it rolls out of bounds for an LCU throw-in as we move 5 minutes into this contest. Kane has it. Gets it to Shaban. Nearly a great pass. DuPriest able to sneak in there and poke that one away, and got to be impressed with the connection from Kane to Shaban so far.
Griff's definitely looking for him. He's a little speedster out on the edge, and you can tell Griff's looking for him to get that through ball.
This one played forward. And a nice job by LCU to play that back. Gets past Brian Jones. He'll sneak it over to the middle of the field from the near side to Kaufman. Far side to Bell. David Bell drops it off to Enrique Souza, who struggles to stay on his feet after contact from the midfield, and he's able to pass that one away. And an early substitution as Nambila checks out. He's kind of hobbled a little bit, and Quentin Jackson, Rampage, checks into the game. That's one of those that my partner here, Trent, saw early on the roster and said, hey, Rampage Jackson's on the
team.
He's
got a quality name for sure.
I bet he gets that a lot. As Gary Ruse tries to get that one forward to Souza. Souza has to come back, but makes a nice pass to Gary. Ruse tries to battle through two defenders and falls down and gets the benefit of the doubt there. The call and a free kick opportunity, and the always dangerous Enrique Souza will take it.
Yeah, you see good skill on the ball there by Gary. He knows where the ball is at his feet at all times. You know, it doesn't ever get away from him, and he has the ability to get around people for sure.
As the wind is slightly coming out of the south, Hillcats moving into the south end zone, and a header opportunity there. I think that one either off the head of Shaban or Kaufman, and over for the crossbar and out of bounds, and a goal kick here for LCU. Hillcats in their blue uniforms, white numerals, red piping around. As the header by Brian Jones is played by LCU. Near side to Stock. Stock with a nice ball forward, but just a little too strong, and Jeremy Swift comes up with it. Hillcats, white numerals, red going around the numerals. Kind of a white piping, white RSU across the chest. A white stripe just above the back of the, or just at the bottom of the jersey. And a foul called against Ryan Kaufman, and a
Kick here. Good aggressive play there by Ryan. It's a good spot on the field to commit a foul and get your team a chance to get back behind the ball.
Hillcats also have blue shorts, blue socks. LCU in the white uniforms, blue numerals. Kind of a lighter royal blue, I guess you could say. White shorts. And white socks with a blue stripe. Ball played into the box. A missed header there by Billy Forbes, and the Hillcats will play it out. Harmon gets ahead on it. Sosa makes a play, and LCU comes away with it. Martinez to Forbes. Near side to Stock. Nice job by Marco Bupa to get that one out of there. DuPriest into the middle to Horrigan. Far side to Dosal. And a foul called. I believe it may have been a handball on Forbes. So Ryan Kaufman will place that ball down on the turf here at Soldier Field and kick this one away. Comes near side to Marco Bukva. Bukva to the far side. Trying to get to Enrique Sosa. That one will sneak out of bounds and a throw in here for David Bell. About 10 minutes, or make that 8 minutes, excuse me, into this contest. 0-0 the score. As Bell throws that one in, has it come right back to him, and it's to Sosa. Unable to sneak by the slide tackle of Dozel. And a quick throw in by Enrique to Harmon. He plays it back to Bell. Bell plays it into the box, and it's played out nicely by LCU. Counterattack by the Chaparrales. Plays that one too far out in front of Forbes, and Brian Jones will be there. He'll get rid of it quickly into the middle of the field, and LCU has it. That's Martinez. Jorge Martinez to Forbes. Controlled by Friesen. Friesen has great height and stature in the middle of the field. 6'1", 185 pounds. The junior out of Edmond, Oklahoma. Ruse fight for it and falls down and loses to LCU. Play there. Harmon will end up with it. To Kane. Near side to Bukva. Nice ball to the feet of Bukva. From Kane to Friesen. Back to Bukva. Near side to the end line. He'll jump over and it'll go past the end line, and a corner kick opportunity for the Hillcats. And Gary Aruz will take it.
That's good work by RSU there. Finding feet, finding the open man, and definitely good work between Marco Bukva and Justin Friesen there on the 1-2 to get down to the corner. Smart play by Marco, knowing the defender's going to slide in and take that ball out of bounds. So well done all around.
Hillcat men are posted up about 10 yards behind the back post. Here's the kick, played to that back post, a header by Kaufman, header by Sosa, and Kane was right there, but a nice job by the goalkeeper Gans to come up with that one. Quick counterattack, and Forbes is on the run. He'll get a kick on it, that was Bell that got a kick on it, to Swift. He'll play over to the far side to Ryan Kaufman. Kaufman down the far sideline. That one will eventually roll out of bounds, and Dozel will pick it up and throw this one away. Here's the throw in by Dozel. Played to midfield. Sosa has it. Is that a Tiffany Roberts side?
That was Tiffany Roberts.
Just all kinds of former Hillcats on hand today. Saturday game. It's a great opportunity for some of those former players to come out. As Brian Jones has it. Jones room to dribble. Tries to get it to Shaban, unable to do so, as knocked out of bounds by Knowles. Bukba will throw this one in. Knowles knocks it away and kicks it up near the grandstands. Sure enough, does so. Marco gets the quick throw in to Griffin Kane. Kane has it. Friesen, nice job to go around the head referee Edwin Smith and get it to Shaban. Shaban on the near side, into the middle, and a great header opportunity by Enrique Souza. And a nice cross by Muhammad Shaban.
You know, I think that's the first couple touches Justin Friesen's had this game, and I think it's going to be important for him to get a few more touches on the ball. He is very good at making some plays happen, as you can see right there.
Friesen, a talented player in the middle, the junior out of Edmond. Nice header by Brian Jones there to sky up over Forbes.
You're not going to win too many of those over Ryan and BJ there in the back.
Brian Jones stands at 6'4" tall. Goes up and gets that one. That was a good foot above. There's the throw in by LCU. Friesen's there, fights for it. Rue's fighting for it, comes up with it. And Justin has it. Works it around one guy, and a great pass to Shaban.
Take him on.
Shaban one-on-one, shot attempt, back post. Oh, just sneaks on the outside of the back post, and a great shot opportunity by Muhammad Shaban.
Yeah, he's a freshman that's continued to impress. You know, like I said, always finds himself in the right place at the right time. He's gotten a few good balls coming in from the midfield, Justin and Griffin. Definitely making the best of his time here on the field now. I look for him to make a good connection on one of these shots coming soon.
That was a beautifully placed ball, trying to sneak it in on that back post as Gans, the goalkeeper, came to the near side. Kane has it. Kind of does a loop-de-loo and loses it to Forbes. Tries to play it forward, but taken in by Brian Jones. Kaufman had it for a second. Forbes comes away with it in a shot attempt. Deflected by the Hillcats and is cleared out by Marco Bukba. And they're going to say corner kick. I wasn't sure if that one stayed in or not. On the near side.
Two guys up front for LCU definitely have some speed on them. I think maybe our back line has underestimated the speed they have a little bit. And look for them to, you know, adjust to that speed a little bit more here coming on.
Forbes and Jackson are the two you speak of. This one's played into the box. Shot attempt, well high. That would count on most Saturdays on most fields this size for 3 points.
Yeah, a little ambitious there, I think. Outside the 18, taking the volley. It's beautiful if they can make it happen, but not too often you get a solid connection out of shots like that.
Jorge Martinez, a little sophomore out of Louisville, Texas. Missed header opportunity by Justin Friesen, just goes over his head. Harmon controls it to Friesen. Hard pass, nicely controlled by Friesen. He'll play it to the far side to David Bell. Bell gives it a little run, and hard first touch and lots of contact as that one goes out of bounds, and Enrique Souza will take the throw in to Gary Aruz. Aruz, a nice touch out to Souza. Far side, guarded closely by two men, tries to nutmeg one, unable to do so, but the guy has to give it up as he goes out of bounds. Souza comes back, forces it into the box, and it's taken over by LCU. Knowles has it. Turns it up on Shaban, and he's guarded closely by Shaban yet again. This one played forward, and Kaufman gets the head on it, directs it over to Bell. Far sideline, David Bell. Up to Enrique Souza, the nice header there to Adam Harmon. Just slips by Harmon, but he regains control. Nice slide tackle by LCU on Harmon, and they come away with it. Try to feed it into Forbes. Jones is there. Knocked out of bounds by Gorey for LCU. And I'm going to say it's a throw in for the Hillcats.
That's good work by Jones there, getting in front of that forward and beating him to the ball. It's definitely what you like to see.
A LCU controls it on the far sideline. This game very similar to the women's game now, at least in the first half, just a lot of back and forth in the middle of the field. I'd give the slight advantage to the Hillcats.
Yeah, lots of midfield play. Good play by the Hillcat midfielders finding the through ball. I think these forwards for LCU are pretty dangerous, so they have speed and some skill we've seen so far. We're looking forward to an exciting rest of the game here.
Forbes forces Fukuda to get rid of that one a little earlier than he probably liked, and he gives it up to LCU, but quickly taken away by Brian Jones. Jones with the ball into Enrique Sosa, and an excellent play by LCU's defender, Aaron Dossel. Knocked that one. Friesen has it, and he's brought down. And slide tackle by Knowles.
It's good aggressive play by Griff leading to the turnover there, and I don't think there's any argument with that tackle on Friesen.
She came up a little high. May have got the ball, but it wasn't until after he got the man. And Bufa is excellent on these three kicks. We'll have an opportunity here from about 45 yards out. Plays it in, back post, header by Aruz, softly taken in by Gans. Quickly throws it out to Martinez. Jorge Martinez over to Billy Forbes. Forbes plays this one well ahead of Jackson, and Jackson tripped up, I think, and led to the easy recovery by Jeremy Swift. Swift's punt, very high, excellent hang time if he was looking for that, but I doubt he was, as Aruz comes up with it, and LCU player limping. Chabon has it. Knocked out of bounds by Dozel. And three LCU defenders closed in on Chabon there, but a nicely played ball by the Hillcats.
Yeah, that's a good first touch by Chabon also. Putting himself in a good position to make a play.
We ask that all spectators please sit on the west side or press squat side of the field. Thank you.
As there will be a corner kick by Roots. This one played in. Header by Brian Jones, and it goes past the back post of Jones on the far side, and nice header opportunity there for the Hillcats.
I like the way we're taking these corners, keeping a lot of guys stacked at the back post and playing the ball over all the defenders and getting numbers up there on the back post, and we've had a couple free looks on corner kicks.
Hillcats have great size between Kaufman, Jones, Friesen. Chabon's not a little guy as he nutmegs him there. Gives it up to Aruz. Aruz loses it. Chabon was making a run. LCU has it and trying to make an attack. Brian Jones makes an excellent job of stepping in on that one and freezing with a nice touch. It's away. It's past a trip, and that one just too far out in front of Chabon and taken in by Gans. Enrique Sosa's 5'10". Mohamed Chabon listed at 5'8", but he may stand a little bit taller than that. Both guys have gotten heads on the ball here in this game. Nice job by Ryan Coffin to slide in, and not sure about that one.
I don't agree with that, no.
Nonetheless, Edwin Smith is going to say, and that might just be one of those that he's trying to cool it now, then have to try to regain control later. But
yeah, you can't blame him for that. I don't necessarily agree with that call there, but that's one of the things of the game there.
Nonetheless,
up to the opinion of the ref.
Forbes will look to take this free kick. We'll say it's about 24, 25 yards out.
It doesn't have a great shooting angle coming up from about the corner of the 18, but I'd look for more of a cross here than I would have shot. I think Jeremy Swift knows that.
He's got three guys. Make it four on that back post. Here's a shot. And it's played well over the crossbar. And Hillcats will have a goal kick here. As it looks like TJ Martin has hopped up. I'm going to guess that's Grant Smith as well.
I think that might be Chase Walker.
Or maybe Chase Walker, yeah.
Looks like Coach Larkin might be looking to add a little speed to the front line.
Sosa has it. Tries to sneak it by. Header by LCU. Bell closes back on it. Kaufman has it for a second. Try to get rid of it. Gets it to Sosa. Plays it back to Kaufman. Kaufman just clears this one up, and Shaban will run after it. Excellent speed by Shaban. Gans has to come out, and he quickly rolls it to the near side. Friesen steps into the passing lane there to disrupt it. Justin goes sliding
good
in
work.
And comes away with the disruption enough to get the ball back to the Hillcats. Bell has it on the far side, back line. Tries to work it into Sozen. Good job by LCU to step into the passing lane there. Kaufman going up against Forbes. Forbes has it. Shot attempt near side. And Swift comes away with that one. That was a low liner. Kind of slid up the arms of Swift. Popped away from him for a second, but he's able to corral it. Punt this one away. High flying punt. Lots of backspin on that one. Nice job there by LCU to get it to Forbes. Another hard shot. Swift has that one played off his body, and he needs to catch that with his hands a little better.
Yeah, that's two in a row. I think we'd like to see Jeremy bring those in, catch them first time. Neither one's been too dangerous. Nobody really following the shots up, so hasn't been detrimental at this point. But, yeah, we'd like to see Jeremy catch those with his hands first time.
Played back to Forbes. Forbes loses it. LCU turns it over, and Griffin Kane comes away with it to Roos. Off the foot of Knowles, and a throw in here for the Hillcats. Aruz will take it. Well, he'll defer to Marco Bukva. 23 minutes remaining. Hillcats tied with Lubbock Christian, the Chaparrals. 0-0. Shaban had it for a moment. Loses it. A header out by Knowles. Good touch by LCU and get it back out to Knowles on the near side. He plays it forward. Kaufman gives chase. And Jeremy Swift comes away with it. Swift has great height. Stands at 6 feet 4 inches tall. 180 pounds. In the box. Bukva doesn't get away with it quickly enough, and it's knocked out of bounds by Stock. Tony Stock, junior out of Louisville, Texas.
And now we're seeing Chase and TJ come into the game. I think we'll see a little bit of an adjustment in the style of play right now. Coach Larkin might look to get the ball over the top a little bit more with Chase running down that sideline. He's got some uncomparable speed, I think. TJ is going to have good possession in the middle. He'll be able to hold on to that ball. Maybe look for a little distributing out of TJ Martin today.
That one goes hard off the chest of Muhammad Shaban as Enrique Sosa checks out, as does Gary Aruz. As Martin and Walker get their first action in the game. Martin, a senior out of Oronago, Missouri. Chase Walker, a senior out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. Bookbook. Clears this one up to Harmon. Controlled by Martinez. Martinez tries to get around Friesen, and great job by Justin to take that one away. Play to the far side, trying to sneak it past the last defender, trying to get it to Walker, unable to do so, and LCU steps in the way.
It's unlucky. That's a good idea on the ball there by Justin. I think that's what they're going to look for there is Chase on the through ball down to that corner. Let him run a little bit.
Shaps have it near side. As the Hillcats have it. Kaufman to Friesen. Friesen down the line to TJ Martin, near side. Martin stops it, almost stops it on the end of the line. He's going to want that one back.
I think so. I think he was looking across, looking at the ball he was going to play, and then ran out of space before he realized.
20 minutes remaining in the first half. Take this time to thank our sponsors, TTCU, Tulsa Teachers Credit Union, Community Home Health, Spectrum Paint, Suburban Chevrolet, Eastern Oklahoma Orthopedic Center, and Melton Sales. As Chase Walker has it on the far side, tries to get around the defender, does so with great speed, gets to that end line and has to try to cut it back, and it's called out on LCU. Quick throw in, goes to Harmon. He loses it inside the box, played out. and LCU comes away with it. They get it to Forbes. Forbes tries to get around Bell, and a great job by David Bell just to step in there, and a takedown by Forbes, and a foul will be called, and a free kick for the Hillcats here.
That's a great work by David Bell, getting in between the the attacker and the ball, and you know, giving himself opportunity to take possession there, and well done.
Looking ahead, the next live broadcast on our...
He's really elusive guy.
The north end of the field, as Bell plays this one, and it's headed right back out to Bell. Over to Kane, closed on quickly and taken away by LCU. Forbes has it. Bell guarding closely. This one played up front. Swift will come out. Misplayed. Clear. Ryan Jones just rips down the defender. Edwin Smith nearly wanted to stop the clock to card him there. As they'll have a free kick. About 10 yards out of the 18-yard box.
Yeah, this is a dangerous place to give up a free kick right there. You know, I don't think that was intentional by Brian Jones at all. We'll look to see Jeremy control this wall here, and it's a dangerous spot to defend from. Jeremy sets up his wall to the right post.
To the right of Swift. That one's set up. Looks like Forbes will take the kick. Just got the results from cross-country meet. Just more work, but more than happy to have it. Shot attempt by Forbes and a header there by... That Brian Jones that got a head on it, knocked it over the post. Pretty dangerous play.
That was pretty dangerous. Brian knew what he was doing. I don't know if Larkin really liked the looks of that, but it worked out all right.
It's one of those that if it works out, it's okay. If not, then you're complaining, as LCU has a corner kick here. Far side corner played into the box and cleared out by the Hillcats. LCU will reset with DePriest. The far side to Dosal. Dosal plays it into the box, played out by Kaufman, and Knowles will have it. TJ Martin comes in and comes away with it. Great job by TJ.
Like to see Chase
Muhammad Jaban.
This.
Jaban gets it to Chase Walker. Walker has it, slows it down for a second, tries to get around. Left footed shot, deflected. TJ Martin's there with a header and control by Hunter Gans. Quickly thrown out to Stock. To the middle of the field, Martinez. Far side to Gorey. McDonald had his touch. RSU trying to come away with it. Forbes has it, plays it behind teammate Stock, and the Hillcats will have a throw in here. Knowles gets touch on it, freezes, comes away with it to Walker. Into the middle of the freezing. Knocked down just outside of the box and a no call. Not a whole lot of contact there, just misstep. Maybe just tripped up a tad as well. Bukva has it, plays this one in. Jaban giving chase, goes to the outside. Fighting Knowles for it. Trying to come away with it, get over top of him, and they're gonna call that one against Muhammad Jaban. They're going to say he tucked the arm of Byron Knowles.
Yeah, I think Edwin Smith might be calling the second foul there, which, you know, that's the one you get caught for. So you got to know better than that.
We had Edwin Smith a couple of games ago, and seemed to be the case with him a lot, as Friesen has it. Plays it up to TJ Martin, tries to sneak it over the defense. It was intended for Martin, a nice header there by DePriest. Martinez has it. Jorge Martinez plays it forward and a shot attempt back post and a goal by LCU. Billy Forbes goes back post with his left foot and LCU jumps out to the lead here, 1-0 over the Hillcats.
That's just a strong counterattack there by Lubbock Christian. Again, I think the center backs, Brian Jones and Ryan Kaufman, might underestimate the speed that this forward up here for Christian's got, Billy Forbes.
A nicely played ball by Martinez on the counterattack. And Forbes was able to just put that one on the back post with the left foot.
Lubbock's really connecting some passes here. Looks like they've got a little confidence now. They're stringing more than a few together. I'd like to see the same come from Rogers State. Get some connections with those balls over the top.
This throw in goes over the head of Chase Walker. Played back, and Forbes has it. Gets a chest on it. Played over to Jackson. Jackson plays this one into the middle of the box. Buchler plays it back, and Swift clears it out. Nice header by T.J. Martin. Shaban comes up with it on the far side, trying to get around the defender. Tries to turn it back up. Goes out of bounds on Shaban, and they're going to say it. Yes, it went out on Shaban, and a goal kick here for LCU. So 11 minutes, 50 seconds remaining here at Soldier Field. Steve Braun, Trent Baker, happy to have you with us on rsuhillcats.com/live. Friesen controls it for RSU to Walker. Walker gets around one defender. Knowles closes in. A cross by Walker. Missed header by Shaban. Griffin Kane is chasing after it. Played down the line and out of bounds, throwing RSU.
Yeah, that's what I want from Chase. Getting down the sideline like that, getting the ball whipped across. Good numbers in the box. Hope for somebody to get on the end of that.
Keep getting opportunities like that. Got to think you'll eventually connect. Try to pull up the live stats to see where we are on the shots on goal and saves. LCU has two shots on goal. 9 shots total. Make that Rogers State. 2 shots on goal, 9 total. LCU, 3 shots on goal, and 7 shots total. Martinez came away with that one. Played too far out in front of Forbes.
Yeah, Justin's going to be disappointed in himself with that one. I look for him to work really hard for the rest of this half. He's a good, solid player in the middle.
Ball goes over the head of the LCU defender. Kane comes away with it. Sneaks it into T.J. Martin. Nicely played out to Chase Walker. LCU takes it over. Knowles has it. Byron Knowles. He has Stock on the near side. Plays it to Stock. With a cross into the middle to Martinez. Martinez pitches this one into the box. Back post. Dangerous play for the Hillcats. Played out by McDonald. Low rolling shot. Forbes has it inside the box. A shot attempt and a goal by Billy Forbes. Goal LCU with 9 minutes and 29 seconds remaining.
Yeah, it looks as though everybody on the Hillcats back line and midfield is expecting somebody else to go get to the ball. And nobody's stepping up. Nobody's getting in front of the players, challenging for possession.
So the Hillcats trail it 2-0 to Lubbock Christian after a pair of goals by Billy Forbes. Harmon has it on the far side. Plays it in the middle to Justin Friesen. Comes near side to Marco Bukpa. To Friesen. Just out of the run of Friesen. Bukpa fights for it. Will get called for the foul as he pulled down Stock. And that was a close call there. And Edwin Smith will give the advantage to LCU. Free kick taken by LCU, and Jackson has it. Shot by Jackson, wide left, and Swift will have a goal kick opportunity here with 9 minutes remaining. LCU leading 2-0. Forbes fighting for it. Nice job by Kaufman to slide in and come away with that one. Got to get rid of it quickly. Swift kicks this one away. Goes off the head of Forbes. Header there by the defensive back of LCU, and they play it forward. Bukva. Bad touch there. Goes to the far side. David Bell somehow keeps it in, and Chase Walker has it. Walker tries to get around one, gets it to Chabon. Gets it back from Chabon. Chase Walker. His attempt deflected out of bounds, and it'll be a corner kick for the Hillcats.
Yeah, that's what you get with Chase. Brings great speed down that sideline, and if you can get him in some open field, he's got the ability to get around people, get past, and make things happen coming into the box down there.
So TJ Martin will have the corner kick from the far side corner. Plays it in front post, headed back, and Ryan Jones is there, and he'll watch it go out of bounds, and a corner kick for the Hillcats on the near side corner.
Yeah, I like the corners coming from this side down here. We've seen some good opportunities from the Hillcats with that size they've got there in the box.
Here's the kick by Martin. Play to the back post. Header by Brian Jones. And just sneaks out of bounds on that post on the far side. Nice job by Brian to get ahead on that one and direct it like he did. LCU will have a goal kick here, leading 2-0 over Rogers State. 7 minutes remaining in this one in the first half. LCU controls it. Trying to play to Forbes. Gets it past Jones. A touch by Forbes, and you can make it a hat trip for Billy Forbes. LCU jumps to a 3-0 lead there as he was able to chase past Ryan Jones. And it snuck past Jeremy Swift for the third goal by Forbes. 6 minutes, 48 seconds remaining in the first half, and LCU leads it 3-0. Hillcats will look to try to rebound with something here in the final 6.5 minutes.
Yeah, you can hear Griffin down there barking some orders to the rest of his team. He said they're going to have to figure it out, and I think he's exactly right.
Martinez comes away with it, gets it to Jackson. Out to the far side to McDonald. Donald guarded closely by Harmon. Bell comes away with it, trying to fight past, and does, and held down by McDonald, and that'll draw a foul and a free kick for the Hillcats. 3-0 the score. Forbes scored on that one from Martinez. Free kick taken by Bell. Sneaks pass, and Chase Walker has it land right at his feet. Volleys it up. Friesen fighting for it. Gets a head on it. Chase Martin. TJ Martin. Getting all kinds of names in here. Chase Walker has that one go out of bounds off an LCU defender, and a corner kick opportunity for the Hillcats here. Far sideline. TJ Martin will take it with 5 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the first half. This would be a great way to get a goal early. Header by Brian Jones, headed out by LCU. Brian Jones with another header and saved by Gans, and they're quickly rolling out. Jackson tries to get it to get it in, and a shot taken by Bukva, and that's well high and out of bounds. And stoppage of time here is make a substitution for LCU. Forbes will check out.
Yeah, Marco, not a guy who takes too many shots. I think we've seen it right there.
Funderburk will check in. Brett Funderburk, freshman from Humble, Texas, stands 6 feet 6 inches tall.
Yeah, not too many people make BJ and Ryan look small back in the back, but he's standing over them.
His coach jumps up when Kaufman won that header there. If you're 6 feet 6 inches tall, you probably should come away with the ball more than anybody else.
Yeah, I think so. That's
dangerously played out. Swift kicks it, and it ricochets off. They're going to call a handball on LCU, and Hillcats may have got lucky there.
I think so. I think that's another testament to the aerial ability there of Brian Jones and Ryan Kaufman. You know, you've seen guys taller than them, but it's more than about just being tall. You got to know when to time your jump and have the ability to get up there and use your body to get in front of people and make a play on the ball.
That last play poorly played by the Hillcats and saved by a handball, even more so by the ball going off the post right at the corner. Knowles will play this one to the far side. McDonald's there. Donald plays it to Jackson. Out to Gorey. Plays it near side to Stock. No one guarding yet. Buka comes in on him. Stock has it. Dribbling around inside, right in front of the box. To Jackson. Saved by Swift. Excellent job by Swift. And an offside there on McDonald on the rebound.
Yeah, good job by Jeremy to stretch out and make that save there. You'd like to see a little more defending coming from the Hillcats. Somebody getting to the ball, stepping and getting in front of these attackers from Lubbock Christian.
As LCU controls it, near side to Knowles. He'll play it to Stock. Into the middle to Jackson. Back out to Stock on the near side. Played into the middle and a header out by Brian Jones. Friesen will head that one out, and then Buka plays it up to Kane. Hit off of Knowles and a handball there on Byron Knowles. Buka quickly puts that one down and plays it to Harmon, to Friesen. To Kane, slide tackle, no one home. Hillcats just unable to get anything going here in the first half for the last 15 minutes or so. 2 minutes remain in this one in the first half. Kaufman steps into the passing lane there, plays it out to Chase Walker. Quickly booted out by LCU, and Swift has to come in and kick that one away. Can't able to get it down to his feet. It's a late slide there. Knowles gets around the defense, unable to stay up. And they're going to call a foul there on the Hillcats, but I think that had more to do with the black mats than the Hillcat defenders.
Yeah, you know, and if he calls that slide in coming on Kane, then that play doesn't happen.
That's very true, as get a free kick here for LCU. And Quentin Jackson. Knowles runs right in front of him, and he'll dish it off. Knowles crosses this one to the far side as 1 minute remains in the first half. Hillcats will have a throw in for Adam Harmon. Harmon with it. There's a foul called there.
I think you take this as the last shot of the game. Get everybody forward. Take the last 25 seconds to get a good ball in.
Time's stopped on this one. There's an injured player for LCU. Hillcats will have a free kick. TJ Martin will take it. With 22 seconds remaining. Substitution for the injured player. I believe that's McDonald. Check out. He's taking his time, but I don't think he knows that the clock was stopped. So quick sub here. Chase Walker for Lubbock Christian checks in. Martin plays it in to the 18-yard box. Header by Jones, and it's just wide right.
Can't fault Brian for going for goal there. But I think we would like to see that ball come back across the face of the goal, give somebody else a little shot at getting that into the back of the net.
10, 9, 8, 7.
That seems to be the way the Hillcats score on headers more than when they can head it one way and head it back across the goal. As we end the first half here, the Hillcats trail it 3-0 to Lubbock Christian at Soldier Field. First half thoughts from Trent Baker.
You know, I don't think the Hillcats have had bad attacking, or you know, they've had their opportunities, haven't had any success at finishing. I think the defending has been a little bit lackluster. I think at first, you know, they didn't anticipate the speed that Billy Forbes had there, and you know, but once they'd seen it the first time, you got to say that they'd make an adjustment and get it right after that. But Billy Forbes definitely made the most of all his opportunities. You know, when it's not working out for RSU, I'd kind of like to see some changes made, get somebody in there who's going to change the style of play, change the pace of the game. But it's not what we saw, and we'd like RSU definitely is going to get a talking to at halftime. Like to see them come out strong in the second half. Maybe Lubbock Christian with 3-0 lead right now might, you would think, could possibly come out maybe a little slow. And hopefully RSU can take advantage if that is the case. You know, they've got some work to do in the second half.
That's Trent Baker as the Hillcats trail 3-0 to Lubbock Christian here at Soldier Field. We'll take a 10-minute break, come back with second half here as RSU trails it 3-0 to LCU.
I'm
in goal for the Hillcats, number one, Nathan Inger.
As you can hear the PA announcer proclaim, Nathan Inger gets the start in goal now for the Hillcats. Here in the second half, as Rogers State set to get things underway, Enrique Souza and Gary Aruz are back into the starting lineup.
Yeah, we saw them sit for a while there in the first half. It's good to see them back on the field.
As Inger's got the start, and Hillcats will look to turn things around. As there's a header by LCU. Ball controlled on the backside by Lubbock Christian. Nice job by David Bell to come crashing in, and he'll pick up the quick foul. That's the kind of tenacity you want to see, though, here early in the second half when you're down 3-0. You want to come out with a little bit of fire.
Yeah, I'm sure Larkin kind of got into those guys in the locker room a little bit at halftime, and I think you can see David Bell bringing that a little bit of that out onto the field there.
Hillcat team that has high expectations on this season. As LCU has it now on the near side, that's Adam Goodnight.
Good tackle by Ryan.
Goodnight gets it back, plays it in the middle, header out by Brian Jones. Off the head of Kane. Fight for it by Griffin, and Muhammad Shaban comes back on it. It's played to a ruse by Shaban, and LCU will reset things with Horgan. Over to Martinez, near side to Dussel. To McDonald. Martinez turns it, heads upfield, and tries to sneak that one through four Hillcat defenders, and Adam Harmon comes away with it. Tries to get it to Shaban, back to Harmon. To the far side, Friesen. And Horgan will reset things for LCU. Plays it in the middle of the field, and nice job by Friesen to rip that one away. Aruz has it for a second. It's taken away by Horgan. Griffin comes away with it. No foul there, and they'll get David Bell for a little extracurricular there.
Yeah, RC's definitely playing with a little more intensity this half. You can definitely see them coming out of the locker room. Pretty tough.
Edwin Smith trying to get control of this one just a little bit. As the free kick will be taken by Aaron Dossel. Dossel's free kick played into the box, headed out by Ryan Kaufman. Shaban will run back and get it. Fight forward on the far side, get it to Aruz. In the middle to Friesen. Tries to get it past the defender, unable to get it up to Muhammad Shaban, and LCU has it again. Martinez to the near side. McDonald. Played out by Kaufman, and that'll roll up into the grandstand. Throw in for LCU. Hillcat reserves are down in the end zone, stretching.
David Bell getting a talking to by referee Edwin Smith. Right now I think he might be in the makings for getting a card on the next one he's committing.
There's a difference between playing with some fire underneath you and just going out there trying to cause contact, and I think that's what David's doing right now, just taking out frustration. And good job by Edwin Smith to maybe slow that down a little bit. Gary has it. Aruz plays it forward, tries to get it to Friesen, and that pass just off the mark, and that just seems to be the deal for the Hillcats today. Passes aren't just as crisp as they could be and aren't to the feet of the Hillcats today. Free kick taken. Quickly played up to Chase Walker of LCU. In the middle to Martinez, Friesen comes away with it to Kane, to Friesen. To Bukva. Bukva's pass ahead, grabbed by Shaban for a second, knocked out of bounds, and a corner kick here for the Hillcats. And a good opportunity here for RSU as Gary Ruse will trot over. Get set up with this one.
Gary Ruse.
Ruse left footed shot, curved in. Friesen gets a foot on it, deflected out. See if he'll play it back out to Ruse. He does. Ruse will get a left foot on this one. It's headed in and past the post, out of bounds, and a goal kick here for LCU.
I think Ryan's got to call Siobhan off of that ball there.
Ryan Jones will take it for Inger. Here's the boot by Jones. Vaughn gets underneath it, tries to play it forward to Ruse. That one's too far out in front as Dupriest is there, and Ruse will just have to run that one out of bounds on the back of Dupriest. And a goal kick here for Hunter Gantz. Bukud goes up for that one, goes over his head. Out of bounds, and a throw in here, RSU. Gets it into a Roots. Plays it forward to Freeze, and LCU just steps into the passing lane and kicks it out of bounds. And a throw in here for the Hillcats yet again. Bukud will take it. Tries to get it to Siobhan. Siobhan gets a head on it. He'll come away with it for a second, try to get through the line of defense. And they're going to say Siobhan pushed down, shoved his way through.
I think that's got to be a foul call there by Edwin Smith. Siobhan gets the ball past the defense, and he's dragged down before he can make a run onto it.
Looked like he got tripped up first, too. And no call nonetheless, and a throw in here for LCU. 37 minutes remaining here at Soldier Field. Rogers State taking on Lubbock Christian. Siobhan tries to get past the defender there, and he's tripped up yet again. He's going to argue for that one because he didn't get the last one, and that was probably the lesser of the two evils.
Yeah, maybe not so much of a case and argument for that one, but I think definitely in the first one he had a case there. But, you know, if it continues to happen, he's going to get some of these calls.
Frustration building for the Hillcats here. They're going to call him offsides on that one. And
yeah, just a mental error there.
Quick kick played out to Knowles. Byron Knowles plays that into the middle of the field. LCU plays it to the far side. And down the sideline to Walker of LCU, and that one runs out of bounds, and a Hillcat throw in. Throw in taken by Bukva. Play into the middle of the field. LCU will try to get away with it. Enrique Sosa gets his first touch in this half. Harmon to Friesen. Kick forward by Friesen, taken in by Knowles of LCU. Byron Knowles resets it. Plays it to the far side to Stock. Back to Knowles, back to Stock, and out of bounds by Bukva. And a throw in for the Chaparrales. There's a ball played by Roots to Kane. Nicely played into the middle of the field. Not a Hillcat there on the run in that particular area, but played back by LCU's to Friesen. The far sideline, Siobhan keeps it in. Still in bounds, and a nice play by Knowles there to knock it away from Muhammad Siobhan of the Hillcats. LCU has it near side, McDonald to Walker. Back to Dosal. Tries to thread it down the sideline, and it's knocked out of bounds, and the Hillcats will throw it in. That's David Bell to Enrique Souza. Souza has it. Adam Harmon comes up with it. Bell. Back to Kaufman. Kaufman just plays it off the feet of the defender. Caught a handball on Chase Walker of LCU. So free kick here for the Hillcats. 33 minutes, 50 seconds remaining. Misplay by Brian Jones there. Just got a little lackadaisical with it and able to recover and get it back to Bukva.
Good ball.
Nice ball by Marco Bukva down the line to Mohamed Shaban. It played in. Enrique Souza was there. It went through his legs, and Aruz was unable to attack on it. And coming away with it was Hunter Gans, the goalkeeper for LCU. Ball played by Friesen to Souza. Souza just tries to roll that underneath his foot to Aruz. Not enough power behind that pass, and LCU comes away with it. Bukva steps into the passing lane of McDonald. Bukva to Souza. Chip shot to Shaban. That one's played high in the air by Knowles. And eventually headed out of bounds by LCU, and a throw in for the Hillcats. Looks like TJ Martin will check in. Substitution. Martin enters. Griffin Kane will come out. While Chase Walker checks out for LCU.
Number 13,
and Quentin Jackson checks in.
And for the Hillcats, number 2, TJ Martin.
Throw in by Bukva to Aruz. Unable to go through three players of LCU and has it taken away. And McDonald has it. He'll give it up to Goodnight. Adam Goodnight. Have to say goodnight to that run. It rolls out of bounds, and a throw in here for the Hillcats. I've been waiting to use something to deal with that name. Hasn't been in. He's only been in the first or this half, but still. Bukva has it, far sideline. Plays this one forward. TJ Martin on the run. He gets sneaking around. There it is, in line and out of bounds. Nice job by TJ to weave his way around the defense and the goalkeeper. Eventually goes out, and a goal kick here for LCU.
Yeah, that's great work by TJ there. Wish he could have finished that, but, you know, he did a lot, did very well to get past all the guys he did. Unlucky that he couldn't finish that.
LCU kicks this one away. Gans with the goal kick. Keeper for the Chaparrals. Bukva throws this one in down the line. It goes out of bounds, and LCU will have the throw in. They get it into Gorey. Martinez waves off Goodnight. Passes it back to Gorey. Back line to DePriest. Over to Horgan. Middle of the field to Gorey. To Martinez. Jorge Martinez near side to McDonald. Middle of the field to Martinez. Jorge plays it back to Dosal. Far side to Stock. Tony Stock has it, gives it up to Jackson. Quentin Jackson played closely by Brian Jones, and Edwin Smith just tells him to get up as he fell down, Jackson that is. Hillcats have it, Enrique Souza plays it to Friesen. One touch and he'll get it to, try to get it into Gary Aruz, and Aruz went up, and they'll probably call it a dangerous play there. Free kick taken by Martinez near side to McDonald. 30 minutes remain. Hillcats trail it 3-0 to Lubbock Christian. Played into the middle to McDonald. Nice job out David Bell to play it. Knocked down by McDonald and call against McDonald, and Bell will have a free kick.
Yeah, knowing the type of player David Bell is, I look for him to maybe get a little payback for that later on in the game.
Never good when the assistant ref has to come out, and Kaufman just kicks that one away. And a throw in here for LCU. Hoffman kicked it. But Edwin Smith's going to allow the Hillcats to re-kick. Can't say I've seen that very often. Brian Jones takes this one. Bond gets pulled down, and he'll have a free kick there. And good job by Muhammad to get position, force the defense to bring him down.
I think we're seeing the aggressiveness of the Hillcats coming to play for an advantage for them now, as looks like Lubbock Christian's getting a little handsy. We might see that play to RSU's advantage here.
Sosa's ball played into the box. Hits off a couple LCU defenders. TJ Martin takes it to the end line and runs it just out of bounds over the flag. Just unable to stop his momentum there. And a goal kick here for LCU as they'll check Billy Forbes back into the game.
Down to the game for Lubbock Christian, number 7, Billy Forbes.
Yeah, Billy Forbes definitely made the most of his opportunities in the first half. So he's got 13 goals on the season through 9 games.
Ruse with it, looking for a little bit of clearance, unable to get some, and has it taken away as Martinez runs into the open field. Enrique Sosa comes back on it, does an excellent job of avoiding the foul and causing havoc enough to get the turnover. Talking about Forbes, at this point, nearly 10 games for the Shaps. This is their 10th game. He will have 16 goals on the season. Enrique Sosa with a shot there from 30 yards out, and it goes wide right, and a goal kick here for the Chaparrals.
It's definitely an impressive performance this season so far by Forbes. You know, it's no matter what way you put it, 16 goals in 10 games is very valid performing.
Forbes, a talented player. Sean Surge, we saw him, and Carlos Zuta, former Hillcat players, teammates of yours.
Yeah, Des Bryant showing up. Des Fitzgerald showing
Des
up.
Fitzgerald, the, yeah.
Des will kill me for that one.
Des Bryant. That'd be something if the Cowboy wide receiver was here. But Des Fitzgerald was here. Talking about how talented Forbes is, both of them were impressed. Excellent speed and causes a lot of problems for this Hillcat defense. The Hillcats got to give Chaparrals a lot of credit. Hillcats have made some mistakes, and LCU has capitalized on every one of them.
Yeah, that they have. I would say not BJ's best performance in the back, but that can change. You know, it's a rough foul there by Lubbock Christian's Nick Glory.
Not really a dirty play either. I mean, it was just a lot of contact. Justin was going one way, and their player going the other is knocked down. So free kick here for Enrique Sosa. Played in, Aruz gets a foot on it. It rolls right over his and cleared out by LCU. Harmon's there for Rogers State. Double teamed and just loses control of it on the sideline. Throw in for Chaparral. 25 minutes, 25 seconds remaining in this contest. Lubbock Christian leads Rogers State 3-0 here at Soldier Field. Steve Braun and Trent Baker, happy to have you with us. Forbes comes back on that one, makes a nice little move of the ball. He'll get it back near side to Martinez. Back to Dosal. Out to Forbes on the near side. Forbes plays it forward. Brian Jones gets a head on it, and Enrique Sosa will try to head that one along. Probably not the best idea by Enrique, as LCU has it in their own offensive third. Here's a shot by Stock, blocked by Fuqua's backside, and that one just sneaks by the Hillcat defense, past Jones and past Bell, and goes out of bounds. And I'm going to say it didn't touch. Well, nope. Edwin Smith will say it did hit off one of the Hillcats, and they throw in here for LCU. So a dangerous opportunity here for LCU against the Hillcat defense. In their own offensive third, a throw-in. He'll go up on top of the hill, run down to get some momentum. Throws it into the 18-yard box, headed out by Kaufman. Here's a shot attempt by Forbes, and doesn't connect all the way on that one. Easily recovered by Inger.
Yeah, I think that's the first ball we've seen Forbes miss hit tonight.
Great punt by Nathan Inger, headed by T.J. Martin. Gets it to a ruse. Taken away, Martin trying to chase after it. Turn the corner, unable to keep it in bounds, and it's out of bounds, throwing quickly by LCU. And Enrique Souza steps in on that one and able to knock it out of bounds. Another throw in for Corrigan of LCU. Corrigan, excuse me. See when there's an H. As it looks like we're about to have a line change. Enrique Souza went up for that one, and dangerous play. He knew it was a bad idea going up for that one with his foot. Caught the LCU midfielder forward on the head. Played in the box, headed out by Kaufman. There's a shot attempt and a goal for LCU off the deflection by RSU, and it's Quentin Jackson with the fourth goal of the game for LCU, and they lead it 4-0 over the Hillcats, 22-36 remaining here in the second half.
Yeah, it looks like Coach Larkin's about seen enough. I think we've got seven subs coming in for the Hillcats right now. He's definitely trying to send a message to his guys that, you know, this kind of performance he's not going to tolerate.
Try to do our best to get names and numbers of the players coming off. It looks like Enrique Souza, T.J. Martin, Ryan Jones, Justin Friesen. As we'll run down all the names that are in. Harmon's still in there. Kaufman's still in there. Is that Garen Hayes?
Yeah.
Garen Hayes is in.
Looks like we've got Tyler Rector in the midfield, Grant Smith up top.
Yep.
Patrick Seward in the midfield, Chase Walker
Chase
up top.
Up.
Nathan Garcia, center forward.
And Michael Adamson on that back line as David Bell and Marco Bukva, or Bukva is still in there, excuse me. Just looking for him on that defensive line, and he wasn't quite there. And as I talk about Marco, he gets called for the foul. Battling around on the sideline right in front of the LCU bench.
Yeah, I think Marco might have to watch his mouth here. Looks like he could be possibly heading for a card.
I think he's pretty frustrated as well.
I would definitely agree with you.
Senior out of Croatia. Can't be happy with this performance. None of the guys are. They're definitely the seniors are the ones that are going to be the most frustrated with it.
Yeah, it's not exactly the conference start the Hillcats were looking for.
There's a touch by Grant Smith, played out to Tyler Rector. Controlled by Hunter Gantz.
Number 3, Tyler Rector. Number 11, Chase Walker. Number 13, Grant Smith. Number 14, Garen Hayes. Number 18, Patrick Seward. Number 19, Michael Adamson.
Chase Walker with it. The Hillcat version of Chase Walker, that is. Tries to cross that one in and has it taken away by LCU. And they'll play it on the far side. That's Tony Stock with the ball. Plays it to the middle to Gorey. Around Gorey, excuse me. Out to Forbes. Billy Forbes to Martinez. Header by Bukva. Clear that one for a moment. Nice touch. And Jackson comes up with it. Forbes has it on the near side. And he's going to pull it back a little bit. He could have had an excellent opportunity on this near side and decided to pull it back, give his teammates a shot here. That one's chased out of bounds and a throw in here for our shoot. I think this is just an instance where Coach Kyle Beard's trying to keep Forbes in there, get that game experience just a little bit. keep his legs fresh, and got to think he won't be in for much longer.
Yeah, I would say so. You know, for Lubbock Christian, you know, their entire roster is lots of freshmen, lots of sophomores, and a few juniors, and so I think he's definitely getting valuable experience out of the rest of this game for most of these guys, along with Larkin. You know, he's got, I think, four freshmen in the game right now. Give him a little taste of what Sooner Athletic Conference soccer is all about.
LCU, only the second year for this program. As they'll take a throw in on the far side. Toss it back, and taking that one away is Justin Dupreece. Near side to McDonald. They'll play it back to Dosal. Dupreece has it. Ball played back to the midfield stripe, and Jackson has it. Into the middle to Gorey. Under 20 minutes remaining. Hillcats trail 4-0. Gorey comes away with it near sideline. Looking for something to do with it. Crosses it. Just outside the box, headed out by Marco Bucco. Nice job by Marco to clear that one out. Horrigan has it. Near side to Dosal. To Corey. Or Gorey, excuse me. Brian Kaufman plays that one up to Chase Walker, the Hillcat version, and he'll have it into the 18-yard box. His shot attempt deflected out by Horrigan, and a corner kick by RSU.
I think you can see the frustration through Ryan Kaufman right there, trying to kind of coming out, taking the ball himself a little bit, you know, trying to make a play.
Tyler Rector will take the corner kick on the near sideline in the north end zone. Here's the play, header by Chase Walker, and it's just wide right. And a nice job by Tyler Rector and Chase Walker to connect on that one. Seconds remaining in this one. Hillcats trail it 4-0 to Lubbock Christian. Garen Hayes comes away with that one. Gorey slow to get up, but finally does, and Haynes come away with it as little activity behind the LCU bench. Looks like they're going to sub here soon, possibly. A couple players warming up and getting up off the bench. LCU has it on the far sideline. That's Knowles. Guarded closely by Grant Smith. Knocked out of bounds and a throw in by Knowles. Looking for somewhere to go with it. Knowles plays that one into Justin Friesen. Or excuse me, not Friesen. Looking at the wrong roster there. That's Tony Stott. Had the right number. They gave me credit on that one.
Yeah, I think so. I think pace of the game has definitely slowed down a bit, which can be expected. Pardon me.
Looks like a stoppage of time here for an injury. Substitution. Gorey's going to come out. And they'll play the ball, start the clock. 16:30 remaining in this one. RSU trails 4-0. Adam Goodnight checks back in. That one's deflected out in a corner kick for the Hillcats, and Tyler Rector will be there to take this one. The Owosso native, played at Owosso High School, freshman. Near side corner in the north end zone.
You know, Brian Jones is out, but you got Garen Hayes in there, who's a redshirt freshman. He's also 6'4".
Played in the near side, out of bounds, past the end line, and just repeat the cycle.
Yeah, it's pretty good in the air as well.
Rogers State corner kick, number 3, Tyler Rector.
Play by Rector, the backside. Kaufman gets a head on it. Bicycle attempt, nearly, by Nathan Garcia, and it goes over the crossbar, and a goal kick here for LCU.
Once again, you know, I'd like to see a little more communication out of the guys. Looked like Patrick Seward had a, you know, running shot towards the ball, and Garcia takes the bicycle, and so you'd like to see Seward, you know, call him off of that so he can get himself a good shot on it.
Strong kick by Gans is headed by Kaufman. Grant Smith. Chase Walker to Michael Adamson. Adamson unable to get around the defender the first time. Chips this one over and has it cleared out by LCU. Harmon fighting for it against Forbes. Good. Forbes drops the shoulder there to keep Harmon off. And
good
here
tackle.
Comes Hayes sliding in and coming away with it. Nice touch to Chase Walker, and Chase Walker has it sneaked by the keeper. Shot attempt by Tyler Rector, deflected by a LCU defender. Rector trying to get around that defender now. Turns it, chip shot into the box, headed out by Knowles. Crisis averted by LCU there, and missed opportunities for the Hillcats.
Yeah, that all started with a strong tackle in the back by Garen Hayes. Gets forward, gets the counterattack going. That's what you'd like to see out of a guy coming onto the field.
Nice ball there by Nathan Garcia, just unable to sneak past the last defender. Adam Harmon has it now. Plays it near side. Chase Walker. Walker's shot. Cross into the box. Off the mark for Ryan Kaufman. As Kaufman's moved up from that center D defensive spot. At least for a second. Looks like he might be in midfield now.
Yeah, in these sort of situations, you know, Ryan's the type of player who's good on a ball, very calm-headed. You know, he gets free rein, you know, in this sort of situation to kind of run around and control the game as he sees fit. He's a smart guy.
As Forbes has it and just kind of slows down on that one, plays it slowly to Stock, near side, McDonald. Has it taken away by Hayes for a second. Forbes comes away with it. Nice play to Martinez. Back to Forbes. Forbes plays it back to Horgan. Martinez. Into McDonald. Into the box. Cleared out by Ryan Kaufman. Chase Walker looking for a quick throw in here. Gets it to Nathan Garcia. Horgan recovering. Grant Smith sneaks in off his leg. Chase Walker's there. Smith has it. He'll round the corner. Look to cross it in. And a great save by the keeper, Hunter Gantz. Nice job by Hans to go down and snag that one. As 12 minutes, 20 seconds remain here. Garcia comes up on that one and lowers a shoulder on Forbes to come away with it. Shot by Garcia, and that one's over the crossbar, and there's an injured LCU player. Knowles is down. Looking for the sub here. Coach Kyle Beard.
Now to the game for Lubbock Christian. Number 14, Gabriel Mendoza.
Gabriel Mendoza checks in. Garcia has it in the middle. Loses control of it, and there's a foul against Garcia and a free kick opportunity for LCU. I'd like to see him get that one to Grant Smith, but unable to do so.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right there. You know, it's nice to showcase your talents a little bit as a freshman, but, you know, you're still behind here. And I'd like to see some good quality soccer played.
11 minutes to go. Chase Walker comes back on that one, and not really a hard foul. Acting like it's a lot harder than it really was. He just came in and lowered his shoulder to make a play on the ball. Knocked down Martinez.
Doesn't take too much there. You know, if you get your shoulder in somebody's back, I think I got caught for that quite a few times. You know, you're coming in full speed, coming in trying to catch up to somebody, and, you know, just a little nudge.
Makes it look a little bit worse than it really is. As Jackson takes this one, Inger will go up and punch it out. Probably could have just snagged that one out of the air. It's out of bounds, throw in by LCU. Play it back to Horgan. Nice job by Kieran Hayes to clear that one out. Horgan has it now for LCU. Far side. Goodnight. Goodnight has it. Crosses it up. Here's the cross into the box, back and into the goal. Wow. Adam Goodnight snuck that one in on the back post, and he's even shocked by that one.
Yeah, that was unbelievable. I don't think anybody saw that.
Amazing curve on that one, and I think everybody thought that was going past the back post.
Yeah, I was looking for it to come out of bounds, you know, and then you see the side net and catch it there. I think even the goalkeeper, Nathan Inger, was caught off guard by that. I don't necessarily believe that was his intentions on the line over there to make that a shot, but it worked out that way.
Nonetheless, an impressive shot and goal by Goodnight as LCU is trying to get some substitutions in. Hillcats just want to get this game over with.
Yeah, you can see it in their body language.
Edwin Smith's taking his sweet time on this one, and I think that's frustrating some of the Hillcats just a bit, as the two captains for Lubbock Christian, Billy Forbes and Jorge Martinez, check out. Not a bad day for those two.
Yeah, impressive performance by Billy Forbes today.
Martinez, I believe, had two assists as well. On this one, he had two of the assists for Forbes. Hillcats will quickly throw this one in. 9:36 remaining. Hillcats trail it 5-0 here at Soldier Field. Steve Braun, Trent Baker, happy to have you with us. Grant Smith has that one taken away. Comes back on it. Gets it back for a second. Harmon gets in on it. Goodnight. Garcia, and Garcia's called for the foul there, and free kick opportunity for LCU.
Yeah, Grant Smith's a guy who's gotten quite a bit of time in the past couple years, and is coming into his junior season. I don't think he's seen the field quite as much as he'd like to, and I think you can kind of see it in the style of play. He's looking a little antsy on the ball sometimes, but he's definitely a quality player. And I look for, you know, further along coming through the season for Grant to, you know, get back onto his game and probably see some more time in the near future.
Garen Hayes with a nice header to get that one out, but Buchwitz having to give chase as LCU has decent numbers here in the offensive third. Play this one into the box. Michael Addison misplays it, comes back on it, and makes a great slide tackle to come out of the box, and good job by Michael there. Come away with it. Harmon steps into that one and picks it off. 8 minutes remaining. Hillcats trail 5-0. Take this moment to thank our sponsors, TTCU, Tulsa Teachers Credit Union, Community Home Health, Spectrum Paint, Suburban Chevrolet, Eastern Oklahoma Orthopedic Center, and Melton Sales. Header opportunity by Harmon. The rebound attempt. Rector doesn't get a good touch on it. Cleared out. Kaufman comes away with it. He'll clear this one forward. Garcia comes in, and he'll get called for the foul there. Trying to make a play on the ball and just tripped up Horgan there. Ball throw in for them. Garcia will come up to throw this one in.
Looks like he might have a long throw, judging from center backs all pushing forward. And he does.
Deep throw in. Kaufman goes up for the header. Nice job by Haynes to punch that one out.
It's an impressive throw in by Garcia there.
Very impressive. And good job by Haynes to come up and contest Ryan Kaufman for that one. So corner kick here for Tyler Rector.
I'd like to see Ryan Kaufman get up and get him a goal here.
Here it is, played in. Michael Addison came crashing in, unable to connect on it with his head. Rector gets it back, can't keep it in bounds, and it goes out for a throw-in LCU and a substitution as well. 6 minutes remain here at Soldier Field. And it looks like, I'm going to say Justin DuPriest will check out. Yes, DuPriest out of the game. Jared Gillespie in. For LCU. Chaparrales run down the scoring for LCU. They scored 12:55 remaining in the first half off a goal by Billy Forbes from Jorge Martinez. Back post with his left foot on a counterattack by the Chaparrales. Good job by Gans to come up on that one and rolls that away. Second goal from Forbes. So he had three on the contest, got the hat trick. Forbes fights in the box and is able to just turn around and connect with a left under the crossbar past Jeremy Swift. And then the third one, kind of the dagger for this Hillcat squad, was another one from Forbes from Martinez as he just snuck by and was able to connect on that one to get the 3-0 lead going into the half.
Yeah, I agree. Billy Forbes definitely, you know, excellent performance today. And you could see the just dramatic change in the Hillcats' style of play after, you know, the first one still they hit good play going on. Second one, you know, turned down a little bit. But after his third goal, completing his hat trick, yeah, definitely you could tell the Hillcats felt it after that.
Second half, the scoring didn't stop for LCU as Jackson had an 18-yard goal just outside that, or just right on the 18-yard box line and was able to connect on that one, sneak it in. And then the final one so far, don't expect another one in the final 4:20, but 9:42 remaining. Adam Goodnight from about 30 yards out on the far sideline was able to sneak it in on the back post past everybody. I don't think anybody on his team even thought that one was going in. As the Hillcats battle for it here, Kaufman comes away and he's drugged down and he gets up and not happy with that play by the LCU player.
You can definitely tell Ryan's a little frustrated right now. I don't blame him.
Senior in this contest. Nathan Garcia tries to pull back the LCU defender, and it's a big boy. Jared Gillespie, 5'11", 200 pounds. Nice job by Garen Hayes to head that one back to Nathan Inger. Adamson has it. Nice ball up to Chase Walker. Walker will keep it in bounds. Look to turn it in. And his touch not enough to Nathan Garcia, and Horgan plays this one out.
Yeah, I think Chase expected Nate to kind of continue his run down towards him a little bit more. Just a little miscommunication there between the two.
Garcia will throw this one in. And know he can throw it in deep. Gets it in there. Grant Smith there, shot attempt, and he just killed that one. And it's going to go out on to Blue Star Drive. And ball boy's going to have to chase after that one. Stop the clock. So they'll make substitutions here. Looks like Brett Funderburk will check in. And a new goalkeeper, I believe that's Tim Sakato. Or excuse me, Charles Pratt.
Number zero, Charles
check in.
Perret.
Pratt checks 18, in for LCU. Foul called there and a free kick opportunity for LCU. 2 minutes remain. 2:15, excuse me. I think both teams just now looking to get this one over. Long drive home for LCU. This one's played in the box. Garen Hayes will clear it out up to about the midfield stripe. Played back by the LCU defense. Just kind of swing it around the horn on the backside. Hayes gets pushed on the header attempt, and that'll draw the eye of Edwin Smith, and a free kick here for the Hillcats. They'll quickly take it. Marco Bufa plays it forward. Also, you're just controlling it in the middle of the field. This one played forward. Kaufman gives chase. Adamson will end up with it. He'll get to clear this one away. And it'll go out of bounds. Chase Walker just watched that one go out. So the Hillcats trail 5-0 to Lubbock Christian. 1 minute, 5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, a lot of obvious frustration right now from the Hillcats.
1 minute remaining.
You have to say you've seen some good things from some of the young guys. Garen Hayes has looked strong in the back past few minutes, and I've seen a lot of class from these guys. You know, no dirty stuff. You know, they've been, I guess, if you can say such a thing, losing with grace.
As a throw in here by RSU, I think it was supposed to be a free kick, but nonetheless, the Hillcats just throw it in and play on. Edwin Smith says, as we tick under 30 seconds remaining in this 5-0 game. Another throw-in opportunity for the Hillcats. Garcia tosses this one in. Played out. Harmon comes away with it. Rector has it. He'll play it back to Kaufman. Kaufman will just boot this one away, and that'll be the final here as the Hillcats lose 5-0 to Lubbock Christian here at Soldier Field. Final thoughts on this one?
Definitely not what the guys expected. I know these older guys, it's not the way they want to start their conference play. You know, still quite a few conference games. They can still make an impact. You know, they have the talent to do it. Just, I think they got out of this game early. And inability to finish chances in the final third towards the beginning of the game. And I won't say bad defending, but Forbes definitely made the most of the opportunities he was given, finishing 3 goals in the first half. And, you know, I'm sure they definitely got chewed at halftime. And, I mean, they came out strong in the second half, just, you know, couldn't find the back of the net. And, you know, sometimes it happens that way. And unfortunately, that's what happened to the guys today.
As the Hillcats lose 5-0, Steve Braun for Trent Baker, thanking you for watching and listening here on RSUHillcats.com. Trent, it's been fun.
It was.
Final score for the final time, Rogers State, 0. Lubbock Christian, the visitors from down in West Texas, 5. Good night from Claremore.